everybody. Hope all of y'all are doing undeniably fan-freaking-tastic out there. Welcome to another episode of Flaming Fiction, the series where I roast various things of fiction. And for today's episode of Flaming Fiction, I'm going to be talking about a probably underrated movie from the 90s. This movie comes from the year of 1998. And yeah, this film, it's kind of funny. Yeah, I definitely gave a few good chuckles for it. But this movie also might be kind of problematic if we're looking back at it from 2023. So, the movie I'm going to be talking about today is called Krependorf's Tribe. Alright, so, right off the bat, we got this lady, Veronica. She showed up to this man's house. She showed up to James Krependorf's house, uninvited, and then she has the nerve to ask this man something stupid.
Can I ask you a question?
Of course.
What are you doing here?
Shouldn't the question be, what are you doing here? A mind that has now discovered a lost civilization that no one is... What are you doing here? That's what I think, because you should be up there.
Hold up. Was she low-key trying to say that James should be dead and up there? In heaven? But you know what? I think I noticed a missed opportunity. You see, the teenage daughter in this film, she's almost like every other stereotypical bad attitude having teenage daughter in the 90s. But keep in mind, James always seems to be running late with something.
Ellie! Shelley! Come on, come on, come on! Wake up! Come on! We're late!
You're late. We're fine.
Children, your biological father is here.
You're late.
No. James, he's fine. Shelly, you're the one that's late. I bet if this was filmed in 2023, you'd be the kind of lady that would be taking pictures of your breakfast and your lunch and putting it up on your Insta-tweetagram or something.
All right, now, this little item here is called by the Shelmikinmu a shootal. It has, as you can see, both a male and a female plug. And it is, in fact, a marital device. It's a Neolithic dildo.
Wow. This man just advertised something made of natural wood to be a substitute for artificial wood.
We're losing the light!
Hey! The Shelmikinmu do not allow the pictures taken without the ritual body paint on.
Hold the heck up. Are we just gonna ignore how he's okay with making his kids do blackface? Not just his kids, but he himself? If this was any more low-key racist, we would be replacing the first K in KKK with Krependorf.
Trepidation. You're really afraid that your brother is gonna chop your wee-wee off. There we go, excellent trepidation.
Oh, so that's what inspired that Val Venus moment. But you know what? I think James Krependorf might be a good politician. He can be very successful just by lying to people. But I'll have y'all know that out of all the other characters in this movie, Veronica, she may very well be the freakiest. I mean, just listen to how she went to bat for the Shikimu tribe.
Our little Shelmikinmu deal with the same problems that we face every day. Loneliness, despair, intense sexual longing.
And if that's not bad enough, she went out of her way to request a Shikimu-themed porno. And if that wasn't bad enough, she tried to organize a watch party.
Shelmikinmu sex videos.
Mating rituals, James. One of the cornerstones of any field research. You did cover them, didn't you?
Don't be ridiculous. Besides, no one is going to want to watch the Shelmikinmu do each other.
Excuse me, ladies. Would any of you be interested in watching a one-hour special on the mating rituals of the Shelmikinmu?
You mean sex videos?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, very interesting.
What night will it be on?
If only Veronica knew what she was requesting at that time. If she really knew what was going on behind the curtain, she was going to be requesting the Shikimu tribe embrace some of that Alabama culture. Now, the scene where James and Veronica are at Miss Proxmire's party and they keep changing over and over again, that has Miss Doubtfire vibes written all over it. Alright, so let's see here. In closing, James Grependorf, he's a liar. He's a deceiver. He almost killed an old lady. He has low-key racist actions. And he's supposed to be the protagonist of this film? Nah. Screw that. James Grependorf, I do not acknowledge you as my tribal chief. So with that being said, folks, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Flaming Fiction. If Grependorf's tribe is one of your favorite moves, I hope I didn't ruin it for you. But if you enjoyed this video, I greatly appreciate it. And if you really did like this video, and if you haven't subscribed already, I would greatly appreciate it if you did. And yeah, until next time, make sure all of you remember to be outrageously optimistic year-round. Booyah, I'm out.